Now let's start adding some logic to our application. When we click on the button, I want to check that the letter that they have introduced is on the word or not. Okay, so for that, let's start adding the click to the button. We are going to create a method, as you know, public void introduce letter. It needs a view. This is mandatory. If the click is coming from the view, it's mandatory to have this in here. Okay. So when we click on the button, we are going to call that method. So if we search for the onClick property, we are going to add the method here. Okay. Perfect. Once we have clicked on it, we need to retrieve the letter that we have just introduced. So where is the letter that we have introduced? So the letter will be in the edit text that we have here. So this means that we need to add one ID to the edit text in order to find it. This is going to be edit text letter. So the edit text will have the letter when you click on the button. So if we go to the activity, we can create here an edit text variable, and it will be find view ID, ID edit text letter. Okay, here will be my edit text. If we click on this light bulb, we can click on cast to Android widget edit text. This is another thing from Java called casting. And this means that this is returning the method findViewID is returning a view. But we are saying that it's not a view, it's an edit text. Because edit text is a child of view. We will see this later. Just remember the concept. This is a casting. And we are just telling here that this is not a general view. This is an edit text. And we know it's an edit text. Okay. Now we need a value. We need to see which value have the user introduced. So my letter will be the value from the edit text. So edit text get text dot to a string. The reason that because we had to do this string is because get text, as you can see here when we write get text, is returning an object editable. So we have to convert from editable to a string because we are expecting a string for a letter. Okay, now we should have the letter here. Let's check that we are doing fine and everything is good. So add a log to check the letter. So this is going to be my log. And in the log we are going to say the letter is one space and then plus letter. What are we doing here? We are going to print this. This is the message, and then we have to go to add to the message one letter. The string variable, it has the property to add value with plus. Okay, this is equals to this. Okay, this is the same. We can add one letter after the other. Okay, so this is what we are doing here. We are going to show the letter is and the value of the variable letter. So let's launch the application. We can write directly in the Animotion the letter, but if you're launching it on the mobile, make sure that you tap the edit text. So if you're launching it in your mobile, tap the edit text. Here I'm just going to write the letter. I'm going to click on check letter. And I am going to see that I have a log here that is saying the letter is A. So if we have If I write more things on the emulator, and this is wrong, I shouldn't do this, this directory is this. Okay, how do we limit the letter to one? So we go back to the view, and the edit text has a property which is length. Max length is going to be one. Okay, so now launch the app again, and we should only be able to write one letter. Okay. So that's all. This method is working. The log is working fine for me. I'm clicking on the button and I'm retrieving the value of the letter. So I like to write the comments for the method. If you write this slash and two asterisk and then you press enter, and it is going to do this. And here is like you add the description of the method. What is the method is doing? It's retrieving the letter introduced on the edit text. Okay, and this is receive a parent, which is parent view from the bottom. So this is B, which is the button click. Okay, I want you to write comments into your method, because if you have any problem, I can easily understand what a method is doing, and it's better for you because you can use this application in the future, or you can show this application to a friend, and this is the best practice, which is write comments on every method that you create, so everyone will understand it. Okay, on the next lesson that we have to do is check that the word that we want to guess has this letter or not.